I am well, thank you, Kamal. Please call me Abraham. How are you? Okay, do I have permission to record this? Good. So, what I'd like to ask you, I don't really know exactly where to start, but why don't we start with the word of the upcoming elections in Syria? I think we can assume that everyone knows what the outcome of that election is going to be since it's controlled by the government. What are the as a person involved in the opposition, how do you see the situation right now for the people of Syria? How do you go forward in this climate?
I think it is kind of a challenge the people of Syria. The military situation on the land, it is for Iranian coalition. So we are weak. We are weaker than the Iranian axis. I think, but the election is not legal for everybody in Syria because also who is respect Bashar Assad or support Bashar Assad don't believe that it is a democratic or honest election. So it is kind of a challenge, kind to speak, I am strong. To be strong, to be a criminal man, it does not give you any legality to control Syria. If you have popularity 99%, you haven't any right to kill the people. So it is the legality, the problem with Al-Assad is the crimes which had committed from him. It is not his popularity. So I think it is kind of announcing I win the battle. I can control Syria by power, not by legality, not by accept of the people. This is the totalitarian regime, the dictator regime, and now the criminal regime. In my point, it would be very dangerous for everybody, not for only the people of Syria, for everybody, because who commit a crime now, he can continue in ruling and can affect all the area, all the territory, and it would be encourage all the criminal groups and the fanatic groups because he gives him the legality to use power against the willingness of the people.
Can you share some of the statistics of what's happened with Syrian civilians? How many have been killed? How many have been displaced? Where are they?
The point is not as appear in the media because we have now nearly 500,000 dead, died because 200,000 killed and registered, and 200,000 hided in the prisons. We don't know is they're alive or not. Also, the regime lose nearly 100,000. Now we are about to 500,000 victims, and the same number of who had badly injured and have problem with them, who is dislocated inside Syria, more than 5 million. And outside Syria, nearly to four. That I think half of the people of Syria now dislocated. Who is still in his home? He is under incubation, under intimidation, under threatened every day, kill every day, detained. I think in Hama, which is not which is now under the control of the regime, they detain every day between 50, 40 and 50. A young man, and half of them disappeared in the prisons.
One of the most horrible aspects of this war has been the use of gas, poison gas, on the population. Can you describe for us whether it has been used more recently after the so-called agreement to remove all chemical weapons from the Assad regime? Has it been used again?
I think Assad regime have more than he announced. He has more than 1,300 ton of chemical weapons, and which he handed not the only the majority of the amount, but he hide a amount is enough to kill all of Syria. So I think also he sent to Hezbollah a lot of technology and lot of materials. Also he used the gas, the chlor gas. It is not so strong, but I think it's enough to kill. It's enough to let the people to dislocate. And he used the sarin gas more than 30 times in Syria before and after the agreement. Before the after the agreement, suspect some points, but we are sure about chlor after the agreement, chlor gas. I think he hide some of this to protect himself, to threaten Israel, to threaten the peoples of Syria. If you going to attack me, I will attack the capital. Yeah.
So many people, of course, are asking, how much influence, how much power do the Al Qaeda related groups have in the fight against Assad?
To be honest with you, lot of our activists move to Islamic groups because they don't have support. Since 2 years, we have the majority of the power on the land. After that, they cut the aids, the supports. They cut the supports. And only the fanatic groups, Islamic groups, have support. So our people, our young men, change directly to achieve these benefits, and they cannot fight without ammunition, they cannot fight without food. That's why we lost a lot of our activists. Now we are working for withdraw them again to the society because we need them, and I believe that they able, but it need a project, it need a budget, it need a support coming through the moderate cover of politics. I think we have to compose a team, a clear ideology, a clear methods, and who respects this method, we will give him the support. This is the way to regather all the people of Syria. You know, in Syria, after 5 decades of dictatorship, no any clear political ideas, no any clear culture for freedom or fear. So we have to expect that there is a lot of people is ignorant. They don't know why or where. They are against the regime, but they don't know which regime they are going to build. So they need help in culture, they need help in politics, and we have to invest in politics, in administration, in organization. It needs that. The problem with the Friends of Syria is not invest in this. They depend on fake representation. They depend on opposition work outside Syria. That's why the situation on land moved to the others who control the land, who have money, who can organize the people, who can. So I believe if we compose the project for invest in administration, in ordering the thing, we can regain the majority of the fighters on the land, but it needs our work. Now we haven't a lot of people work with us, to be honest with you.
Well, one last question, an important one at this point. What is the attitude today of the Syrian people towards its neighbor, Israel, and more generally towards Jewish people? Someday it'll be the era after Assad. What will the relationship be with Israel and with the Jewish people?
The problem is not with the old age or the new generation, but with the middle generation. So the old age, they get used to live with a Jew in Aleppo and Syria, and we know each other. My doctor, when I was a child, is Jewish. So it is not a problem for them to live with Jews, but the new generation have a culture from internet. So it is not a problem with the new generation. But the middle generation, which take the culture of Ba'ath Party as fanatics and nationalists, so this is the problem with them. The problem with who had educated, not who is a simple man. I think now after the revolution, lot of things it changed. And the revolution, it is the shortest way to change. And after we suffer from who resists Israel, we get be very acceptable to Israel because we don't find this kind of war or this kind of attacks. Yes, we fight Israel, but Israel don't bomb the schools, don't bomb the cities, don't bomb just a limited attack for a limited aim. Now the regime, the security, the army, the Arab army kill everybody, amusing himself by snipers. He kills the children, he kills. Because of this crime, everything is a change, the mind is a change, is accepted to change. It's time to go through this mind and to improve him and change him. So I sent my project to take the opportunity now to, I believe, it is time, it is suitable time, because the people of Syria need help in urgent and a little help in Golan Heights for medical help. It changed the situation in the south, very, very large changes, and everybody. Now, I said to go to Israel to have medical care. Just I need this message. I need this message to change. We have not to wait the people to change themselves. We have to help them.
Thank you very much, Kamal. And with your permission, I'll be back in touch with you from time to time.
Thank you so much. We hope to cooperate.
God bless.
Thank you.